Hi everyone. Through this video, I want to give you the last minute message for the advanced exam on Sunday. So you know, only 2 days left. That is, Friday and Saturday and Sunday morning you have this exam, which I call as a D-day. And you have been preparing for this exam from last 2 years. Some of you might be preparing for last 3 years. So this is the final day where whatever you have been preparing since years, you have to do the performance. So the last 2 days, they play a very important role in your performance in terms of how you spend these 2 days can have a level of impact on your performance in the exam. So that the most important thing is how you're going to spend these 2 days. So these 2 days, you have to de-stress yourself. So it means that your physical as well as mental stress. When we say physical stress, you don't have to do any physical activity. For example, you're obviously you're mature enough not to do that. So you're doing too much walking and jogging and running, those kind of thing. Walking is still okay if you're doing in limits. So don't try to stress out your body. Other thing is the mental stress. That's something more important. And mental stress comes when you try to learn new things in these 2 days, or you're trying to put stress on yourself when you do the negative thinking. When you start getting panic that I know this and I don't know this. So the kind of a stress will come into your mind. So you have to de-stress yourself in these 2 days. So it means that you are not supposed to do anything new. It means don't do any new book or new question. Don't attempt that. You just have to revise whatever you have done. And in revision, either you can revise a test paper you would have done in last few months. You can revise your class notes. If something in chemistry that you want to learn towards the end in last 2 days so that you will remember that in exam, so you can do that. So either chemistry notes or class copy or test paper. In test paper you just have to revise question and you should have a solution in front of you. Don't try to attempt question and check yourself. Other thing is, this is not possible to remember the whole syllabus. If you try to just check yourself whether I know this or not, whether I remember this or not, if you try to check yourself by recalling things but checking whether you can whether you remember things or not, that again a kind of pressure you put on your mind and it will bring stress. Don't try to check yourself, judge yourself towards the end. And see the last 4 mock advanced tests you have given, so idea of some of them were really difficult, especially mathematics. I know because I've gone through mathematics papers. The idea of these papers sometimes is that if there is a new trick we come across through a question, we should give that question to you so that you can learn this new trick. Sometimes there can be direct question based on those tricks, right? So it might happen that some of the papers might be more difficult than the advanced exam. So don't think that whatever performance you have shown in these papers is going to be the same, like you're going to perform the same level in exam. So don't definitely the final exam will be more scoring than what you have been doing in last 4 tests. So don't think about that. Don't stress yourself. That is finished. That is gone. Okay. Other thing is that you have to sleep on time and get up on time. That's why I've taken these 2 classes in the morning, so that you get up on time and you start, for your brain should start functioning since morning. So it's important that you have to sleep on time. Maybe 8:30 or 9. Just you have to be on bed because you need a good 10 hours sleep. Though it is very difficult to sleep, when you have so much to coming in your life and exam is there on Sunday, and sometimes you will not be able to sleep on time. But at least lie down on bed, try to sleep, try to relax your body, focus on your breathing. So sometimes when you focus on your breathing, you get to sleep. Try to control your thoughts, because if thoughts will go down, you'll automatically sleep. The other thing is that in these 2 days, let's one more point I want to cover. You have to be in a very positive state of mind, and I stress on this point a lot. If you would have seen my last year video, that you have to, apart from you have to be cool and calm, you also have to have a positive state of mind. Positive state of mind means give a positive thoughts to your subconscious mind. राइट right, फॉर example, यू नो दिस सम इंस्टेड ऑफ सेइंग कि मेरे को क्वेश्चन एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन नहीं आते होंगे या मेरे से होंगे नहीं, इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट डू द पॉजिटिव थिंकिंग. एग्जाम पेपर आता होगा, आई हैव डन माई प्रिपरेशन, आई कैन डू गुड इन पेपर. सो इफ़ यू जस्ट कीप थिंकिंग लाइक दिस लाइक मे बी 2-3 times a day, मॉर्निंग आफ्टरनून इवनिंग, सो इट्स लाइक गिविंग ए पॉजिटिव थॉट्स टू योर सबकॉन्शियस माइंड. एंड वैन यू नो सबकॉन्शियस माइंड इज़ अ वेरी इरेशनल माइंड यू कैन से. सो that when you get in a panic, so that the message will come from your subconscious mind. If you have a confident feeling in your subconscious mind, if you have a positive subconscious mind, so automatically you'll come into a positive state of mind. So if you're in a positive state of mind, you know, all the positive energies will help you in whatever you want to do. So there are other reasons which I don't want to discuss here, that what advantages you get if you're in a positive state of mind, you attract the positive forces around and push out the negative forces. So let's not do that. Just be if the negative thoughts come into your mind, then you have to declare a fight. I don't have to think negative. Everything will go good. Everything will go nice. And then so the other thing is you have to conserve energy. So try not to speak much, not to do much. So because if you when you speak or talk a lot, you just drain out your mental energy. So we have to be with yourself with a minimum level of thought. And if during these 2 days if stress comes to you, then try to calm yourself. And one way you can do is like you can do slow and deep breathing. Take a deep breath and so that you feel that breath and down your belly and then slowly release it. You know that you would have done that in schools also. So it's like a slow and deep breathing. Breath goes inside and slowly release it. So if you and that's also helpful in exam. If you can in these 2 days for some time practice this deep breathing, go at least for 10 minutes 2-3 times a day. This can help in exam because of the moment you start doing focusing on your breath and deep breath, so stress it throws stress out of your body as well as mind. So now the exam day, during the exam you have seen, you have been practicing the test papers in last few months. So the pattern is more or less, it's like the way if you'd have tried the past year JEE papers, the more or less the pattern remains same. Mathematics is generally difficult than physics and chemistry. So the time division, you have to be careful. You should have a sense of time in exam. Generally, it is advisable that you spend more time on mathematics, maybe 75 minutes on mathematics and together, you know, 75 to 80 minutes on mathematics and 50 on chemistry and 55 on physics, or 45 on chemistry and 50 on physics. So 55 on physics, so some you make your formula according to you, but least time on chemistry and then maximum time on mathematics, so it should be around that. And then sense of time when you're doing things, sense of time meaning ki matlab question kar rahe hain, question apne try kiya, you have just, you know, 30 seconds to decide or a minute to decide whether you should continue that question or not. So wo matlab ye nahi ki karte ja rahe hain, because especially in mathematics if you keep solving the question, sometimes you realize 5 minute nikal gaye. So just, you know, there are other questions which you can do in exam. So don't get hang to one question. So, देखो शुरू होने से पहले कि try करूँ, तो पहले वही question उठाने जो आप exam में कर पा रहे हैं. Right? तुमने देखा कुछ idea आ रहा, नहीं idea आ रहा, let's go to the next question. And if you're not able to solve multiple questions in a row, don't get panic. Generally, mathematics out of the 3 subjects is a low scoring. And chemistry में भी जो आता है आपने कर लिया, जो नहीं आता नहीं किया. So that way, and remember that you have to carefully fill the answer sheet, because answer sheet is the thing that will give you the marks. Some people do it like after every question they fill the answer sheet. Some people do it after every section. Some do it after, you know, towards the end when the time is about to finish. I would not recommend that you do it towards the end. Try to do it after every section or maybe after few set of questions. क्योंकि अगर ऐसे भी हुआ है, मैथ्स को फिजिक्स में मार्क कर दिया और केमिस्ट्री के आंसर मैथ्स में मार्क कर दिया, यू कैन नॉट गो रॉन्ग ऑन दिस. राइट, पूरा पैनिक हो जाओगे आप, आपने ऐसे कर लिया फिर दोबारा से आपको करना पड़ेगा. सो दैट वे, सो द फ्यू थिंग्स यू हैव टू गिव योर इंस्ट्रक्शन इन द मॉर्निंग, दैट हैव टू फिल द टाइम शीट केयरफुली, हैव टू कीप अ चेक ऑन द वॉच ड्यूरिंग द एग्जाम, स्पेंड प्रॉपर टाइम ऑन ईच सब्जेक्ट. एंड यू नो मिस्टेक्स, आई डोंट हैव टू डू एनी मिस्टेक्स, सो कीप सजेस्टिंग दिस, यू नो, द बिगनिंग ऑफ द पेपर, मे बी समटाइम्स ड्यूरिंग द पेपर, इफ आई एम डूइंग इट फुल कंसंट्रेशन, मिस्टेक मुझे बिल्कुल नहीं करनी है आज. तो वो राइट, एंड देन पैनिक, समटाइम्स यू ट्राई टू डू अ क्वेश्चन, यू नॉट एबल टू डू इट, यू गेट पैनिक इन द एग्जाम, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस पैनिक स्टेट यू नॉट एबल टू सॉल्व अदर क्वेश्चन विच यू कुड हैव सॉल्व. सो जस्ट कंट्रोल दैट पैनिक स्टेट. जैसे मैसेज किया, मतलब पैनिक हो रहा हूँ, मुझे नहीं होना रिलैक्स, मतलब क्वेश्चन है एग्जाम में करने वाले, जस्ट दैट डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन है, नहीं हो रहे हैं, दैट्स ओके, देयर अदर क्वेश्चन आई हैव टू डू इन एग्जाम, राइट? सो डोंट डोंट ट्राई टू कंट्रोल योर पैनिक बिहेवियर. एंड देन बिटवीन द पेपर्स यू डोंट डिस्कस, डोंट जस्ट इवन गिव अ थॉट हाउ योर पेपर वेंट, इवन जस्ट ट्राई, डोंट ट्राई टू थिंक इट, बिकॉज इफ़ यू रियलाइज कि मैंने ये क्वेश्चन किया था गलत हो गया, मुझे इसका आइडिया नहीं आया, मैं ये भी कर सकता था, इफ़ यू यू नो द लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स विच यू कुड डू आफ्टर द एग्जाम, आउटसाइड द एग्जाम, बट यू वुड नॉट बी एबल टू डू इट इन ड्यूरिंग द एग्जाम. ये होगा जितना आप एग्जाम के बाहर कर सकते हैं, यू नो वो आप एग्जाम में नहीं होता सॉल्व, बिकॉज इट्स अ टाइम बाउंड एग्जाम, स्ट्रेस है ये है. सो इफ यू इफ यू जनरली सम पीपल गेट डिप्रेस वन ये कम आउट एंड दे रियलाइज कि कुछ क्वेश्चन गलत हो गए एंड कुछ को कर सकते थे नहीं किए, एंड इट इम्पैक्ट्स योर द सेकेंड पेपर इन द इवनिंग. सो द बेस्ट स्ट्रैटेजी इज दैट डोंट जस्ट बी स्ट्रॉन्ग, डोंट लिसन एंड सी हेयर एंड देयर, पेपर इज डन, वट एवर आईव डन डन, नाउ नेक्स्ट पेपर. सो इन ड्यूरिंग टू वर्ड्स इन बिटवीन यू हैव टू टेक लाइट फूड, just focus on your breathing and then positive state of mind, and then maybe some formula copy you have, you can revise that formula copy, but definitely no thought on paper one, which would be over. And then, you know, sometimes it happens that during the second exam you start feeling fatigue, because you up morning mein uthe and then स्ट्रेसफुल डे चल रहा है, पहला पेपर हुआ है, फिर सेकेंड पेपर में यू स्टार्ट फीलिंग यू नो फिटीग. सो इट्स जस्ट दैट यू हैव टू बी स्ट्रांग फ्रॉम इनसाइड. अगर लग रहा है कि फिटीग हो रहा है मेंटल फिजिकल, जस्ट मे बी गो आउट फॉर अ मिनट और कपल ऑफ मिनट्स, जस्ट टेक अराउंड एंड कम बैक एंड फिर फुल एनर्जी, यू हैव टू डू इट, जस्ट मोटिवेट योर सेल्फ, आई एम नॉट टायर्ड, डोंट स्टॉप योर थिंकिंग इन दैट डायरेक्शन, ट्राई टू कंट्रोल योर थॉट्स इन दैट डायरेक्शन. सो होगा थोड़ा टायर्डनेस होगा, थोड़ा तो डीप ब्रीदिंग कर लेंगे तो यू कैन यू नो यू कैन थ्रो आउट योर फिटीग. सो द वन मोर थिंग आई वुड लाइक टू कवर दैट आफ्टर द एग्जाम दोज यू नो दोज हु हैव दोज हु हैव टू अपेयर फॉर बिट्स एग्जाम मे बी द नेक्स्ट डे और आफ्टर फ्यू डेज, आई वुड स्ट्रांगली रिकमेंड दैट दे शुड नॉट यू नो गो थ्रू द सॉल्यूशंस, दे शुड नॉट ट्राई टू एनालाइज देयर पेपर इवन आफ्टर द सेकेंड पेपर, इवन आफ्टर कमिंग बैक होम, बिकॉज इफ़ यू नो अगेन द सेम थिंग विल हैपन कि आपको लगेगा मेरा अच्छा नहीं हुआ, ये कर सकता था, वो कर सकता था, मार्क्स लगाएंगे और उससे यू विल फील डिमोटिवेटेड एंड यू नो योर फोकस ऑन बिट्स विल गेट डिल्यूटेड. वेर एज बिट्स इज इक्वली इम्पॉर्टेंट, इट्स इज इक्वली इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड मे बी यू नो सो यू हैव टू डू इट फुल विद फुल प्रिपरेशन विद फुल फोकस फुल हार्टेडली यू हैव टू अपेयर फॉर बिट्स. सो इफ डोंट डिस्कस योर पेपर, यू कैन एनालाइज आफ्टर द बिट्स एग्जाम. So we have to be very strong, as you have strong temptation to look into the you know the solutions and just analyze how you have performed. Just be strong, you don't have to do it. And finally, I want to wish you luck, wish you best of luck for Sunday exam, like from my side and on behalf of every teacher in Vidya Mandir, Bada Bhaiya, Chote Bhaiya, and you know every staff. We personally, I would pray for you that you will perform good in exam, right? Our best wishes are with you, and you just go and do it. Thank you.